Hey guys, welcome to episode 25 of my Let's Play series. Now, last episode, you guys saw me build that dock or whatever this is called. And I went during the night and I finished it. I went all the way around from that corner all the way to this corner. And yeah, it's looking good. So today I want to put in the railings on top. And I want to do some work in and around the base, and then maybe go and explore a bit. Let's just quickly cook some food. Meat stew, 44. I need to go hunting again. 8 minutes. Let's just do this, divide it quickly. Okay, also want to show you guys this. I placed 3 TVs here. I wanted to do those 2 big TVs and then 1 in the middle, but I didn't have enough plastic, so I decided against that. Also made this end table with a lamp, and it's actually cool. It takes quite a few resources, and it takes all of this. So could just make one, and unfortunately, it seems we can't make bookcases. It sucks, I don't know why. Also want to show you guys this. I think we're going to go with this design for the windows, because this is the plate business window. It's not that clear to see out of. I don't know. And then there's this block one. So it's either one of these or this over here. And I think this over here looks better because you can actually see more in the background. I know there's no point in actually seeing anything out here in the water. But it just looks, and also this is extremely expensive. But for me, it's just better that you can actually see through the frame and see what's in the background, the scenery. Just quickly see 12, 24, 36. Another 36. Also, last episode when we took off, I noticed that I didn't break out this top part here. So all of it way around, it was these big ass windows, and yeah, it was the small view. So I broke that out as well. Oh, before I forget, this is also, no. That's 8, 24, 32. Okay, so let's first put in this fence. I actually struggled to get on the name of this thing, because I was looking for railings and there are no iron railings. I thought I was going mad. I think I'm going to leave one open for if I want to run over and jump. So guys, I apologize if you hear a slight grogginess in my voice. I was actually quite surprised to hear in the last recording that my voice sounded a bit weird. Almost sounded like I was sick or something. I think it's because I'm recording while laying down, so my throat is bending in a weird position. Ooh, phew, I didn't take into account the front. Yeah, let's just quickly see. 1, 2, 3. He said 22. Just want to cook it quickly in the forge. And while we wait for that, we can quickly do the rooms. I should actually make doors at the back as well. I think perhaps, yeah. Because I saw, these windows are usually used to just jump out onto the farm. But now I have to run through the whole house to get to the front door. We also need to go and see whether the traders have those steel polish items again, because we seriously need them. Oops, almost jumped onto the fire. Because like I said, we need to make that whole horde base steel polished, and the only way to do that is to buy from the trader. I thought that perhaps we can make our own, but I don't know if I'm just lacking the recipe or what, because I can't access that or find that in the recipes. Okay, so when we're out and about now, I just need to remember to hunt a bit. If I see any deer, I need to kill them. I also intend to make a fence-like thing for the bottom, but since the block itself can't handle anything on top, now I'll show you that it floats. I'll have to do something to the side of it, and I just hope it carries. Quickly drop a few things off, and then see what we still need to get. Also, I want to go to those towns off camera and dismantle all those cars, because I don't want to do that on camera. I actually want to keep the wrenches just for now, since we can make more tables if we need it to. This we can sell, this we keep. I still want to know how we make the diamond auger blade. Also guys, I just noticed, if you guys hear a slight whizzing sound in the back, I have my fan on. It's actually extremely hot here where I am. Okay, so we're gonna get the steel polish if they have, hopefully they have, and then we're gonna get this treasure. That's all for now in the house. When I get back, I don't know if I should keep it like this or if I should break it. Because the whole reason I have it is to get the same view as this, but let me know what you guys think. Do you prefer this broken kind of view? Or do you prefer this? I think this looks more professional, but I'll actually let you guys decide on what I should do next. Actually, a shame we can't make bookcases here, because I really wanted to spiff this place up. First things first, we need to get that treasure, because we might get something that we can sell. I hope my game is more fluent now. I noticed that Windows, because I reinstalled or put in a new SSD, that also counts for my Windows. I had to reinstall that. And Windows actually had quite a bit of crap settings installed, so I just disabled all that for better performance. So let's hope it works. Okay, to the right is a mine. To the right and up, or just quite across. If we come across here, there should be zombies for us to kill, because it's been a while since we were there. So off camera, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to those towns that we were at already. I'm going to dismantle all those cars and make sure that I've looted all the places. Because, I mean, you guys were there with the one town, but the other town, I still have to do or complete. So there's still quite a bit of loot that I can get there. There should be zombies in this area. I'm actually itching to kill a few zombies. Anyways, and then after the horde, I think we can go to the new town. I want to wait until we're level 200 before going to the hub city, because then at least I know that there's little chance that I'll die there. Because if, especially if the hub city is in the wasteland area, then I don't want to go there unprepared. We would have been slaughtered in the day 28 horde if we did it here. I need to remember to make a hunting knife when we get back, because with a hunting knife I'll be able to harvest more meat and bones and everything from the animals. I mean, a fire axe also counts as something you can use, but since it's more for cutting down trees, the finer detail you can't do with it. There's a deer in the distance, but I'm focusing more on animals around me. There's actually a ton of zombies to spawn in a non-spawn area. It's not like we're in a town and yet there's so many zombies. I think it's been such a long while since they actually spawned that when they get an opportunity now, they just spawn everywhere. I'm also trying to keep my eyes open for more animals as we go, hence the stop and go driving. Just need to remember I parked next to that tree. Sometimes I come up and I forget, completely forget where I parked. Except for the ammo and cash, that was crap. Yo. And we already have a blue sniper rifle, so the orange part is a little crappy. I actually wonder what's up there. If there's something else I can reach or not. I should actually, when I have the time, go around the whole peninsula, whatever it's called, the border, and see where the biomes reach. Because, yeah, I think it reaches there. Who knows, maybe there's more than one way to get to our destinations. Okay, what's this? Graveyard. Let's quickly go there. I said this last time. And that's where I encountered the cowboy zombies. So who knows, maybe I can show you guys how they, what they look like. There are actually quite a few, quite a lot, or quite, I don't know, it's like, there's a lot less zombie bears or bears in general around. I'm kind of expecting bears to be popping out everywhere like in previous alphas, but I can't see any. Just let them finish spawning. Come on, where's the bloody cowboy? I was actually kind of looking forward to the cowboy zombie now. They're very weak, but it's awesome to see them. I wonder if there's actually any graves around here, because I don't see any grave marks on the ground. You just quickly... What did you drop? Scrap this, and then blue shovel. Huh, there are coffins. Usually it would show on the map. Oh, come on. Usually it would show on the floor that there's actually something there. Crap. Okay, so let's just take this off the map. I know there's a grave or something somewhere else also. We'll leave that for now. And what was this? Show on map. Oh, drop chest. I'm still busy with this town. New town, hub done. Okay, so now we just head to the trader. Do I have my... Yes, I do. I actually want to... Oh, damn it. I want to pick up this because you can sell it for at trader for quite a bit. Didn't even notice this stag was here. I hate this stun. Come on. Don't wanna lose wellness from just a few hits. I hate how you work so hard to build up your wellness and then just one or two hits from a zombie take away so many points. So there's ammo in there. Oh, I forgot something. And you, I think you guys noticed it before me. I can put stuff in here. Wow. Damn, so I didn't just throw so many things away. And I even said that this playthrough, I don't want to throw things away, and now I do, even though I have storage space on me. Just quickly want to see whether I have done this gun safe or not. Damn, I haven't done this whole place yet. Let's just dump more stuff in the mini bike. What I'm wondering now is, why did I kill all the zombies but didn't loot this place? I've noticed that this game is actually getting a lot more popular, because even a lot of people here in South Africa are starting to talk about the game. And it's just all of a sudden. I should also go to all of these places and take apart all the cabinets. 9, so we can throw that away. We could have scrapped that for cloth, but okay. We can also... So I'm just strip all these places off camera, because I'm not going to bore you guys with that. It's going to take way too long. Turds, we have enough of. We can use this for wellness. Remember guys, these places always have a ladder to the top. This place is actually a very nice place to hide from hordes. Okay, let's just see if we can drop a few things, because we are going to need space if there's gun parts in there. Damn, only 2 slots. For you guys new to this game, what I was doing there is I was shift-clicking all the stuff in my inventory, and if there was something similar in the bike, it would have just gone into the bike. It's actually, in my opinion, faster than looking, because sometimes even the most experienced of YouTubers will overlook the smallest of stuff. Well, at least we can make space by assembling stuff. Funny that he didn't notice me, or get startled by me being in the vicinity. Oh shit, let's just, I can sell this. What can I throw away? Let's eat this. I forgot that I put all the meat and stuff in the mini bike, so now I need space for this. Need one more space so we can get the hides. Or we could have just done that from the beginning. For a moment there, I didn't see raw meat. I saw rotten meat. Okay, let's get going. It's actually starting to get dark, so we need to get to the trader now. Before sundown, and then they lock us out. I actually want to see how far this guy's claim extends. Because then I can just make a ramp outside to ramp in with my bag, instead of struggling to get in through the door. Then again, I have to struggle to get out, but that's a minor.
Ah, I've been expecting you. Great doing business with you.
Let's just check what we want to sell on a mini bike, and then we have to see if he has stock for us. So what I want to sell is this. I think this is all on the mini bike, and then after this I need to go to the other trader and see if he has steel polish there or not.
Thank you,
so first see, does he have, yeah, nope, okay, and under chemicals, just oil, damn it, when's he gonna restock? And this guy has nothing else we need, so, well, at least I think there's nothing we need, yeah? Nope. Ah, does he have bookcases? I wonder. Case, nope. No cases. No furniture. Perhaps we can make or buy lockers for that room. Let's see. 6 will do. Wait, can I only buy one? That sucks. Wow, that sucks. File cabinet. Let's do, make that place look a little bit better. Okay, that's all for now. Fountain.
Nope.
Okay, so we're going to quickly go to the other trader, and I'm going to see if I can get polished there and sell the rest of the stuff. If you guys like this episode, please leave a like and share with your friends. If you have any comments for me or feedback or your opinions, please list that down below or comment that down below. And if you guys are new to this channel, please remember to subscribe for more 7 Days to Die content. See you guys next time.